video hits, Fuzzy and Dylan on the bed, joined now by Chase and Status. Hello, boys.
Hi.
Welcome to Australia.
Hello.
Thank you for having us.
It's all right. You're a little bit tired?
A little bit tired, yeah.
A little bit jet lagged. All good.
Did you get here?
Thursday night. Late Thursday. Had a gig last night, actually, in Sydney. Did a little DJ thing at the Chinese Laundry Bar.
Yep.
Like, utter carnage. Sweatbox.
Yeah.
People falling over the decks. Just, like, wicked. Really good gig.
Yeah, you like that. That's good.
Yeah, got to sleep at, like, 7 in the morning. Got up at 10.
What you have is not jet lag. That's party lag. It's different.
General lag.
Yes, lag.
Hang on. So you went to bed at 7. What time did you step outside of the club?
Probably about 4, 5. Maybe 4-ish, 5-ish, something like that.
So you missed the floods. Did you see any flooding?
Not really, no. I saw the lightning from our hotel room. But I just saw it on the news, like mad flooding all over Australia.
It's gnarly.
Where we come from in England right now, it's freezing and there's been a lot of rain. So, you know,
flooding everywhere.
Getting a bit of rain here and there.
It's not a big deal.
Meh.
Exactly. Yeah. Put the words out of my mouth.
You boys explore a few different styles of dance. Is that fair to say?
Yeah.
Grime, drum and bass.
Drum and bass, dubstep, hip hop.
Electronic, yes, dubstep. I'd like to talk quickly about grime because in Australia, it's taken about 10 years to get here. So we're all only just starting to understand what it's all about. Can you describe what sounds are in grime, what make it grime?
Yeah, I mean, basically grime comes from like UK garage.
Yes.
Which was
a bit of drum and bass.
Yeah,
as well,
one of our favourite musics ever. And it kind of like went, you know, unfortunately, like disappeared. And grime is basically like MC-led music, so that it's, you know, a lot of focus on the vocalists doing their lyrics, and it's a big like kind of bashment vibe where it's all about the vocals. And in a dance, if someone does a really good lyric, and stop the tune and start it again, it's all about that content rather than the beat itself.
Right. And the sounds that are used in grime are sort of oily. Dirty. Sounds?
That's pretty much the only sound that they use.
Dirty, oily.
Oily sound, yeah.
Hang on. Is that when the crowd wants to hear the song again, is that when you say Bo Selector? That term that Craig David has been coined for?
Craig David.
Yeah. People don't really say that anymore, but yeah, there was a time when people said that, yeah. You can say that if you want. It's still
Bo Selector.
Cool. Bo Selector. Yeah.
We're not going to say it.
Is grime dead in the UK or is it still alive?
It's not dead. It's just had a bit of problems because it's quite, you know, it's real music from the streets, so it's got a lot of association with violence and some of the lyrical content's a little bit aggressive sometimes, so it had a little bit of bad press. But much like, you know, US hip hop in America, people like 50 Cent, you know, gangster rap. So, it's still there. It's bubbling, you know, on the underground, and I think that's the sort of magic of it. It's not really meant to be commercial music, so it's just, you know, that kind of raw music from the streets.
I guess we learned it from people like Dizzy.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
He's one of the biggest names. Yeah.
Comes from the streets. To really blow up, you know, he's one of the biggest things right now. 3 number ones in a row.
Mm.
You also got other grime artists like, you know, Chipmunk, Kano,
Wiley.
You know, I probably not mention loads of people that we know. Like, there's so many people out there who come from that and are making some serious moves.
Wearing my Rolex.
Exactly. He's been wearing his Rolex.
Yeah. Can I ask a little bit about some of the other styles you employ? As a punter, I hear these names thrown around: dubstep, electronic, drum and bass. Not sure what the differences are.
Can you explain that?
I might sound dumb, sorry, but I'd love to know.
Drum and bass is very fast. Lots of these music stuff I find are defined by this, with the speed. So drum and bass is 175 BPM.
Right.
Dubstep is kind of like, it's 140 BPM, it's a lot slower, like old school kind of garage, but a lot of it is half time.
So a lot of really focuses on sort of bass, big bass lines. It's got a big reggae influence, a dub. Hence the dubstep, you know, the dub era from Jamaica. Kind of quite cool, sort of, just really, big bass lines and kind of like,
experimental production.
Music. Really
We've
cool.
got guys from England, two of the guys who really like broke the scene, were like Benger and Scream, and they've been to Australia many times as well. And they all started out as music from. I'm waffling rubbish now. I'm on camera as well, so I can't remember what I was going to say.
That's party lag, brother. It's okay.
Party lag.
Anyway,
latest album, More Than A Lot. Some fantastic tracks on there.
Thank you.
Pieces is a standout for me with a bit of Plan B on there. What an awesome talent. Is he here?
Yeah, he's here.
You bring him.
I don't know where he is right now. He's probably actually, I'm not going to say where I think he might be, but
he's here. Doing yeah, exactly that. But yeah,
he's toured around with us. We had a UK tour just the end of last year, and we're good friends with him, so he sort of persuaded him to come and tour with us and as a guest, and he comes on and does his thing. But yeah, it's good.
He's an actor as well, Plan B, isn't he?
Amazing actor. He's taking over the world, Plan B.
And Harry Brown, yeah, the film that he's in, which you have a track on end credits as well.
Yeah.
We wrote the title track to the movie with him, and it went to number 9 in the UK charts, which is incredible because it's not really a particularly commercial sounding track. We didn't think it's not very poppy. It got lots of support, and the movie is fantastic as well. Incredible talent, Plan B.
I love the film clip for Pieces. It's quite disturbing.
The video that we did for that? Yeah, we did that on like about £500, like no budget.
Plan B directed it.
Filmed the entire thing. There's some slightly comical acting from us in there. But it's good. It was a good video. It was quite fun to do.
You assholes for doing what you did to that cat.
Yeah, that cat didn't really burn in the oven.
That's his cat. Cat's fine. He's still with us.
So animal rights groups, back off.
Yeah.
So many people like complained about putting a cat in the oven. It's not that big a deal.
I'm sure people do that around the world.
Around here.
Okay, you guys are also known for your awesome remixes, Jay-Z being one of them. Which track did you guys do?
We did DOA, Death of Autotune.
And how did you hook that up with him?
We do a lot of production with Roc Nation, which is his company. And we were in America just working on some tracks for another artist who will remain nameless. And they just gave us a call saying, listen, do you want to remix DOA? And no one has remixed the Jay-Z tune before. And we said, for years. And we just said, yeah, straight away. And that night we did 3 versions. And the first one we did, they took. And it was a real accolade, real honoured, and done wonders for our career, so we're pleased.
Also worked with Rihanna.
Yeah, Rihanna. We did 3 tracks for Rated R, and had a couple of studio sessions with her, and she's a lovely girl. Again, it was all really like a big accolade for us to work with them, and it's fantastic.
Who are you seeking right now? Who's on your radar?
In terms of working
collaborating with?
I know Busta Rhymes here, so we're trying to get to him and play him some boots.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's sort of being mobbed every time I see him. He's got like a million people around him, but we've got our little iPod with some beats to play him. So, Naughty by Nature, maybe Salt and Pepper reunion. That'd be quite jolly.
Work at this tour, can't you?
Cuddy's here as well.
Making
some serious waves worldwide right now, Kid Cuddy.
Yeah. So we're trying to do.
Basically, we're just gonna try and pick off everyone from here, get a few bars and a few verses. Yeah, and
this is like a networking thing for you, isn't it?
Have a mega song.
Unreal. What are your next plans this year?
I'm going to bed later on and get some sleep, man.
Just sleep right here.
Yeah.
Well, when we get back to UK after the Good Vibrations tour, we're finishing next album. Currently working on that, sort of all we're doing at the moment. And just really excited. You know, it's signed to Mercury Records now, which is a big step up for us. And bit of pressure, like obviously higher expectations of the success of the last one. Just excited to do some new music, lots of big features, and we'll see what happens.
And some collabs with Busta.
Hopefully, yeah. We'll see.
Have a great tour, dudes.
Yes,
thank you for chatting with us today. It's been excellent.
Here's end credits, people. Plan B.
Bang.